Hey, RC people! Oh my god. I don't know if this is freaking real or funny. Or if they're cracking. I mean, it's on a Comedy Central station, so maybe it's a joke. But he really chews out these two ladies right now. Oh my god. Are you kidding me? Check this out, horsey people.
Getting strapped in. I noticed that two other customers who had been booked for the same ride were looking at Heath and snickering. I had already explained to them that we were accommodating an overweight customer, so this behavior was completely inappropriate. So before we headed out, I decided to give them a talk.
Can I ask what's funny about what we're doing here?
It's freaking hilarious! This girl, I mean, she backs down pretty much this guy coming over. I mean, they just totally folded, which I'd have pretty much said, you know what? I don't want to ride with you freaking idiots. I don't want that balloon landing on me when it blows up. And I ain't riding with a bunch of balloons over my horse's head. I mean, these girls, I think they kind of folded a little too easy. But to each their own.
There's three massive balloons attached to a man. Right.
Dude, come on, people. If you saw this, would you not laugh? Rick, you can't laugh. He's overweight. Trying to... Oh, my God. Oh, jeez.
This is the only way he can ride a horse. Would you laugh at a wheelchair? I mean, that's a medical device he's wearing.
Okay. You're 100% right.
Right. Just because he's a larger man.
No, he's not. Three balloons strapped to your fat butt is not a medical device. Oh my god!
And hooked up to giant helium balloons. It doesn't mean...
It's not funny at all.
I like this girl because she's laughing. But I don't like that she folded so easy. Come on, girl! Shoot! Girl up!
Because right. If I see either of you so much as smirk from this point forward, your ride is over.
I cannot believe they sat there and let this dude talk to them like that to ride a horse. Be like, dude, you ain't telling me what to smile and laugh about. I'll laugh at you, you big dummy.
Got it?
Yes. Mm-hmm. All right.
With the normal riders promising to be respectful, and Heath now weighing in below the 220 pounds.
I want to see what he weighs before the balloons, because I don't think the balloons are doing a whole bunch.
Limit.
How's it feel?
Good.
You feel lighter?
Yeah, I feel light. Good.
It was finally time for everyone to saddle up, so the ride began.
Great.
And I watched as for the first time in history, a plus
sign. Oh, shit. Hang on.
So the ride began.
This horse is like, hey, those balloons ain't working. I gotta put a little bubble there. Dude, your balloons are... We got some more balloons. This horse is like, hey, we got any more of those balloons? Rick, you can't laugh. This is hilarious. I can't believe this.
Great.
And I watched as for the first time in history, a plus-size man was able to ride a horse. With my branch blockers trailing close behind and the flying scarecrow overhead.
A flying scarecrow? What the hell is that? Why do you need a flying scarecrow? How can you figure that? Somebody clear that up for me.
I felt that we were ready for anything Mother Nature could throw at us. And it wasn't long until my balloon protection system was put to the test.
Man, if one of these balloons pop on these three horses, now that's a show. Then you're going to see how well a plus-size person can hang on. And why is he the only one wearing a helmet? Girls ain't wearing helmets. Why is the balloon boy wearing a helmet? Can't these balloons protect him? Maybe if they tied these balloons to his head, he wouldn't need to wear a helmet. Rick, why are you picking on a helmet? It's safe. All right, whatever.
As my branch blocking team raced into position to guide Heath through a narrow clearing. And all we could do now was pray.
I'd love to be in the bushes with a BB gun right now. Bow! Are you kidding me? This poor horse is like, what the hell? I got a flying scarecrow. They got a damn barn witch flying around. I got three big-ass balloons that are trying to attack me from above. Now I got these two idiots with two big white fans trying to trap me. This is a freaking great horse for putting up. Meanwhile, he's carrying... Well, never mind. All right, let's go.
This poor horse was flawlessly. And for the rest of the trail, tree after tree, my team was able
to keep... You know what? If you need helium balloons and tree protectors and a flying scarecrow and a car following you to ride a horse, maybe you ought to take up another sport. I'm not being discriminatory here. I'm just saying, just maybe you could take up another sport.
Keep the delicate balloons intact, making the ride a success.
I do kind of like the flying barn witch. Needs a little broom right here. She needs to be screaming. But don't get get the horse. Put on a helmet. You're not doing it right. I do kind of like that idea. All right. Anyway, I'm glad that the balloon boy could ride a horse. All three of these horses are like, what the hell did we get into, man? Picked a bad day to be a horse. All right. Well, that stupid scare. There goes the barn witch. That's what I feel like. They're always flying around just waiting to harp and yell. Man, I bet you if you pulled out a trailer right now, this barn witch multiplied by like 15. They'd be everywhere. Here, let me show you how to do it. You got to do this. Give me that rope. Get another rope. Get a switch. You need to. All right. I digress. I thought this was a pretty funny video. I don't really know if this is true or funny or what, but I think it's hilarious. All right, rolling that there.